Okay, so today I'm going to take you out in the bee yard, and we're going to install two queens. And they came through the mail, and instead of a smoker, we're going to be using Honeybee Healthy. And these are the queens, the way they arrive, priority mail. And they're in their cages, everyone's healthy, the workers are there to feed the queens en route. There are candy plugs on the left there in each cage, and there is a slit cut in the wood here that also provides ventilation, so that when they lay flat on something, they can still breathe. Here is the end with the cork that you do not want to remove because it's opposite the candy side. This is the candy side, and before I go out in the bee yard, I go ahead and remove that cork. Now, the workers in the hives that we stick these into will eat through the candy and release the queen in a timely manner. So here we are again, just a screen, wooden cage, and we're going to go out and we're going to put them in. But before we do that, we're going to mix up some sugar water. So 50-50. This is pure cane sugar. We're going to heat the water up. We're using 2 cups of sugar, 2 cups of pure filtered water. This is the filter system that I use. And when I say pure, it's P-U-R. And this is also the water that we drink. Now we feed it up so that the sugar will dissolve. You want to mix that up really well and wait for it to go clear. Once it's clear, like this, it's also cooling down. That's when we're going to add 2 teaspoons per quart of the Honeybee Healthy. And we shook it up really good first. Here are the recommendations on the side of it. And the purpose is to mask the scent of the bees in the colony. And we're gonna put 2 teaspoons in, just real quick here. Some people like to see every step, so that's what we're doing. And we'll pour that in. It's gonna cloud up the water again. And then we just stir that in really well. And before you put this in, you wanna make sure that that water has cooled down, because super hot water can affect the effectiveness of the Honeybee Healthy. So the other thing is, I have this industrial sprayer that I bought, and I mark it for bees so that we don't use it for anything else at all. So this is the whole kit. We're not going to bring out the smoker. We just have the sugar water. And of course, I'm going to reference the source for the bees. The queens that we bought are from bee weaver apiaries, and they've been dealing with survivor stock, untreated bees, for more than 10 years. So that's why I get my queens from them. I'm going to leave the smoker here in the shed. Not going to use it today. I am going to take my hive tools. I'm not going to use the heavy gloves. We're going to use surgical gloves instead, because we need dexterity. And that's pretty much it. This is going to be a simple evolution. And anytime you're dealing with brood frames, you may run into defensive bees. So let's get out of the bee shed here and go do what we're going to do. Also, I'm wearing my hot weather suit, which has these upper arm pockets. Now, your hive tools slide in here kind of loosely, so if you're going to bend forward and so on, they will fall out. But this is the coolest suit ever. Don't forget to turn off your electric fence charger. Don't ask me why I'm pointing this out. Now here we are. We have the base frame of the FlowHive 2, and we've got the acorn pre-waxed frames in here, and I pulled brood from another colony. So I've sprayed them with the Honeybee Healthy mixture that we showed before, and everyone's calm. As it turns out, using that spray, it does 2 things. One, it provides nourishment for them right away, like candy for the bees. The other thing is, it has a strong scent to it because it has essential oils in it, and that effectively blocks the communication of pheromone that the bees use when they're defensive. So it calmed them right down. As it turns out, I didn't even need this ventilated bee suit. I do use the gloves anyway because I want to keep my hands clean, so I bring several pairs out as I'm dealing with camera equipment. But I'm just going to stick it in here because I want to look at the response to these nurse bees that are on these brood frames. If they started acting defensively, which they could if they reject a queen, but we've interrupted the pheromone, so they don't even care that she's there. So they're not doing 2 of the things we normally see. One is that they would rush up and try to sting. You'd see them bend over their abdomens and try to sting through the cage and kill the queen if they felt that she were an intruder. Now keep in mind, I pulled these frames from another colony more than a day ago, so they've had time to be queenless. And there is sealed brood in these frames, and it's a very small unit, and I went ahead and this is a 8-frame box, but they could care less if the queen is there. They're not acting defensively, but again, we've masked their pheromone, which is supposed to encourage acceptance of a queen. Now we're in the second colony here. Same thing, we're gonna spritz it down. And these are frames of brood. Now by transferring frames of brood, they're gonna have continual hatchings of nurse bees. And those are the young bees that have never been out of the colony anyway, so they're not anxious to take off. And where there's brood, they will remain to preserve them and hatch them out. So we're gonna stick the other queen cage in here. Much the same. Now notice these queens are marked. They have that kind of pink dot on their carapace there, thorax, whatever you want to call it. And this will help me locate them later. Now, everybody's calm. I didn't need a bee suit today. And the bees really don't care at all. I also went around and opened other colonies with the honeybee healthy just to see if it calmed them. And it does. What it does is blocks the pheromone and again gives them something to eat so they're not interested in defending the colony. And we're kind of in a dearth right now. It is about 80 degrees outside. And look at the workers here just licking away at the honeybee healthy. So this is a satisfactory test. You spray honeybee healthy out there and it calms the colony right away, even when you're getting into their brood frames. So I went to the parent colonies and did the same. Now this is just a quick update. People ask about the FlowHive flow frames. Am I still using them? Yes. These are the flow frames that we showed in a prior video where the queen had actually laid her brood in the cells. The bees cleaned them out themselves. The queen went down below and began laying again. And of course, this is today, which is July 11th. And we're almost at harvest point here. Most of the frames are full and they are sealed out to the extremities on both ends. They still have some cells to fill. And it's very easy to keep a colony from being honeybound by just taking out a couple of frames of honey when you're ready. But I just wanted to show this really quick because some people did have concerns when they saw that the queen had laid eggs in there and that she had capped some brood. This is the side that had been capped before. And we've cycled it several times since. It's working just fine. I did not clean those frames. The bees did it themselves. Thanks for watching and happy beekeeping.